to choose foreign language, we'll choose Arabic. اللغة العربية. But it's okay, I'll try to deliver to you. This is a slide about West Nusa Tenggara, glance of West Nusa Tenggara. We have 280 islands with two main islands, Lombok and Sumbawa. Yes, and back in data, yes, this is our demography structure. And it will be projected by 2030 that our productive young people, it will be 67.3% from our population. Alhamdulillah, thanks to God, West Nusa Tenggara attributed as the best human development index mover in Indonesia. We have what we call incremental score every year. The best progress of HDI is in West Nusa Tenggara. And this is the economic growth and open unemployment rate. We recorded for three last consecutive years, our growth is above national growth. Last year, we recorded 5.7%. This is about MDGs. So, West Nusa Tenggara for 5 years, since 2011 until 2015, recorded best implementation of MDGs in Indonesia. The slide shows some of our steps in West Nusa Tenggara. In that, where's the light, Samuel? Is it? Oh, yeah, okay. These are challenges, and after a treatment, this is what we achieve. For an example, the number of illiterates before MDGs, it was 12.8%. And after MDGs, the illiterate remained 2.5%. It is, Alhamdulillah, a good achievement of West Nusa Tenggara. Not my achievement, the achievement of people of West Nusa Tenggara. Yes, this is some of our priority programs in West Nusa Tenggara. We have social development, economic development, and one of our core business in West Nusa Tenggara is tourism. And recently, we create a new segment of tourism. We call it halal tourism. And Alhamdulillah, it contributes on increasing the number of tourism. Our president has a target by 2019, 20 million tourists. And Alhamdulillah, West Nusa Tenggara, we record always among three top growth every year with Yogyakarta and Bali. In 1 year, we are number one, and the other year, we are number two or number three. It's a very good progress in West Nusa Tenggara about, according to tourism. In 2008, our tourists was 500,000, and last year, it is 3.2 million visitors, Alhamdulillah. This is the portrait of education in West Nusa Tenggara, Alhamdulillah. This is, what we did facing the challenge infant mortality rate. Alhamdulillah, the rate decreased and the maternal mortality rate also decreased. We have a special program launched by 2015 in collaboration with our universities in West Nusa Tenggara with 18 universities and academy. We call the program ASHAR. ASHAR is abbreviation of Aksi Mahasiswa untuk 1000 Hari Pertama Kehidupan. student action for the first 1,000 days of life. So our students, they go to village mentoring pregnant mom and teach them how to raise their kids, their baby. This is some example of young people in West Nusa Tenggara who has a very good contribution for West Nusa Tenggara. Nasrin Mukhtar, a very inspiring entrepreneur. Aisha Odis, she initiated Bank Sampah NTB Mandiri, who has been internationally well known with professional system. We have Tuan Guru Hasanen Juwaini. He is from Pesantren, but he is a very progressive one. He got Kalpa Parwinner and before he got Asoka Award from Thailand or Vietnam. Yeah. We have Nur Shada Sams and Risu Shamro, Fawzal Bahri and many others. Ladies and gentlemen, yes, I think enough for the slide. But I want to share with you, I think after those slides, we have same conclusion that there is a transformation in West Nusa Tenggara. And if there is a lesson learned from West Nusa Tenggara, I think, in my opinion, it will first that education is the key. Education is the key. I strongly believe that education is the best tool for vertical mobility for everyone. It is tool for on war against poverty. So it is very important if you want our region, even our nation, become better, strong and prosperous. It is important for us to give priority for education. That's why in West Nusa Tenggara, we consistently allocate 20% of our budget for education. We provide funds for poor students. We give scholarship for many of them, strengthen the quality of teachers, and improve their quality, their teaching methods. Building schools in remote areas and many other programs. And we in West Nusa Tenggara, because more than 70% of our schools are private schools. Those schools built by Muslim community or Islamic organization, built by them, funded by them, and operated by them. We call those schools pesantren. Pesantren plays a very significant role in West Nusa Tenggara. So because of these facts, we treat public and private schools equally in West Nusa Tenggara in terms of grant, subsidy, and many other programs. And that's because of that, we can see that the illiterate, as the slide shows, the illiterate number is decreased from 12.8 to 2.5%. Second, I think when we formulate programs, the experience of West Nusa Tenggara shows that it is very important. When we formulate programs, where young people can involve actively, playing significant role. Their number, as the stats shows, is big, so their role should be big too. That's why when we, for example, when we launch literation program, we build a cooperation with universities. I sign agreement with our universities. They send the students to villages staying 3 months there and educating, literating. And also targeting young people, we have in West Nusa Tenggara what we call 100,000 wirausaha baru, 100,000 new entrepreneurs. More than half of this number are young people. So actually, young people in West Nusa Tenggara play very significant role on Nusa Tenggara development. Third, ladies and gentlemen, from West Nusa Tenggara experience, I think the strength of West Nusa Tenggara is because the unity of its people. Building infrastructure is important, but maintain good values is not less important, if not more important. West Nusa Tenggara, as other provinces of Indonesia, has strong diversity. Many religions, different tribes, different language. Although around 96% are Muslims, but we have big Hindu communities in West Nusa Tenggara. We have many Christians, we have Buddhists, we have followers of Confucianism. And we all live in peace and help, respect each other, building West Nusa Tenggara. So for Indonesia, in the future, Mr. Henry talk about leadership, and Professor David talk about our advantage for the future. I think beside all good ideas, it is very important to maintain our good shared values. And when we talk about good shared values, religion is the most important source of good shared values. In terms of poverty, for example, I'm a Muslim, so I'm talking from Islamic perspective. The Prophet Muhammad said that in Arabic, kadal faqru ayakuna kufran. Poverty to be almost disbelief. So if you are good Muslim, we have to involve in war against poverty. Thank you. May Allah bless us. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Gubernur, for the presentations. It's wonderful progress happening in your province. So now, let's move on to Q&A with myself first as moderators. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give one question for each panelist, and then afterwards I'll give one general question to be answered by everyone.